The star Pushya, the name Pushya that you see now, technically means that nourishment, right? And whichever planet is in Pushya, that planet gets nourishment. Now, every nakshatra is not good for everything. Same is the case with Pushya as well. Getting my point? Like Pushya is considered one of the best nakshatra in the complete zodiac. But whatever comes in Pushya, whatever happens in Pushya gets repeated multiple times. So if you get married in Pushya, you have to get married multiple times. That is a problem, right? So the nourishment or sustenance or, you know, the pushing of Pushya is good only in a few circumstances, right? Right? Is only in a few circumstances. If a good planet is in Pushya, that will be nourished, right? And that nourishment will be good. If a bad planet is in Pushya, then bad thing will be nourished. And that will not be good. And right now, you know, in considering good or bad, the good and bad of planets are not very important. The good and bad of the houses are important. For an example, Mars is taken as a bad planet, right? Because Mars indicates anger, lust, etc. But at the same point of time, Mars also indicates few good things. Mars will indicate health. Mars will indicate love to the motherland. Mars will indicate your ability to protect your family members. So that is not a very bad tendency. That is a good tendency that needs to be supported, right? So planets are not completely bad. They are 50-50. Right, they are sometimes in for some significations they are bad, for some significations they are good, right? But the house lords are more negative. In a planet, if a planet is negative, you take that the 60% of the major significations of this planet is negative, while the 40% can be positive also. Regarding the houses, this thing is changed, this thing is different. Do you get my point? So, this is a very important thing that needs to be taken care of, right? If the sixth lord is in Pushya, then enemies, disease, wounds are supported. If the eighth lord is in Pushya, then see, eighth house is death. But more than death, understand eighth house as misfortune. Because it is told in Laghu Parashari, eighth house is very bad because it is 12th from ninth house. That is loss of the ninth house that indicates misfortune. So when the eighth lord is in Pushya, misfortune is supported. Right? When the 12th lord is in Pushya, expenditure losses are supported. Right? So good planet supported, very good. Bad planet supported is very bad. Right? Pushya means nourishment. And who gets the nourishment is important. A criminal, a bad person getting nourishment is not very good. Should not be considered as good, right? The word that comes in the ancient literature about Pushya is not Pushya. It is known as Tishya. And Tishya something somewhere will mean like a purifier. Something which purifies, right? So this purification aspect of Pushya is a bit problematic. And this purification aspect of Pushya is a bit problematic if you do bad karmas related to the planet. Understand something. Pushya is the birth nakshatra of Jupiter. See, you are born in nakshatra, right? So when Jupiter was born, there must be one nakshatra going on. That is Pushya. Right, so that is the birth nakshatra of Pushya, and because it is birth nakshatra, that is the birth nakshatra of Jupiter, and because this is the birth nakshatra of Jupiter, you have to be very pure and clean regarding the signification of the planet. Because if there is some problem, then that going through the purification of that particular stuff will be difficult for you. Take an example: if the seventh lord is in Pushya, if you are faithful in relationship, faithful with your wife, then it is okay. But if you are not faithful, or if you are not devoted to your spouse, then bad results will come. But it is Pushya, right? It is supposed to give you good results. So after giving you bad results for say 25 years of life or 27 years of life, when you will, you know, try to get married, this pushya will start creating problems in your acquisition of wife, or in getting wife, or in finding the right lady for marriage. And it will like try to delay the marriage, so to give you the suffering that will purify you, so that you can get the good results of pushya. Getting my point? So this is something crucial, pushya, right? The being the birth nakshatra of Jupiter, this particular thing is crucial. Coming to the mantra, Braspate Sutishya, Vritashya belongs to Braspati, is technically what it means. Braspate Sutishya Jyuvata Parastadi Jamana Avastata. Right, this is the mantra. Right? Braspate, if you take this word in a wider perspective, Braspate means someone belonging to Jupiter. But if you take it in a wider perspective, it will mean that Lord of abundance, right? So pushya is Lord of abundance. As I just told you, know, pushya is bad for marriage. Why? Because pushya gives everything in plenty, multiple options. And this is what I teach in every class, right? That exaltation gives thing in multiplicity. Exaltation is multiplied by three. So when you have vehicle, when you have three vehicles, it is very good. When you have three properties, it is very good. Even having three children is better. But having three wives are not very good. Right? That is dissatisfaction from two wives and happiness from the third one, right? That is not good, isn't it? So the Lord of abundance or Pushya Nakshatra indicating abundance should be taken carefully. And good planets should be in Pushya only. Bad planets should not be there in Pushya. Right? When a good planet is there, you are blessed by the signification of that planet. For an example, you know, this is even told by Varahamihira. Sorry, Parashar. Parashar tells that planet enjoy nakshatras. Right? The good and bad result of the nakshatra is enjoyed by the planets. Take it as the planets are living in a particular nakshatra. And as per the tendencies of the nakshatra, the mood of the planet will change. And if a planet is in a good mood, he will give you good result. If a planet is in a bad mood, he will give you a bad result, right? So, and you know what? You must have known avasthas in astrology, right? There are avasthas. Baladi avastha, mritadi avastha, diptadi avastha, etc. The most important of these avasthas are Shayana Netra Pani Ityadi, Shayanadi Avastha. Like the most extensive, the most detailed, and the most important one is the Jagratadi Avastha, Jagrat Swapna Susupti Upavesha Netra Pani Ityadi. And these avasthas are calculated based on the nakshatra occupied by the planet. And that is very crucial and very important. Let me tell you one particular thing. I will give most importance to the nakshatra of the planet rather than giving the importance to the Rashi, Navamsha or any other position. Specifically to decide good versus bad. Mind it. See, I don't use nakshatras very much in my interpretation. I am not a person who will be like, you know, your fifth lord is in Pushya Nakshatra, so you will be nourished by your children. These fantasy stories I will not tell in a consultation, of course. But let me tell you one particular thing, right? If you have your seventh lord in, say your seventh lord is Mars. And if you have that seventh lord in Bharani, that is not very good. Despite being in own sign, like that is multiplied by two, that is okay. Right, so that is a bad, suppose fourth lord, right? Fourth lord is Mars, that is in the fourth house in Bharani. It is not good. Despite the fourth lord being in the fourth house in own shine, this is not good because that is in the nakshatra of Bharani, that is a negative nakshatra, that is a bad nakshatra. So despite the fact that this person will have multiple vehicles, he will have problems related to vehicles, that sir, I am not able to enjoy the vehicle, my vehicle is being used by other people, etc. Getting my point? This problem is supposed to happen if it is in a bad nakshatra. Getting my point? At the same point of time, you know what? I have a debilitated Venus. Suppose. I have a debilitated Venus, suppose. That debilitated Venus is supposed to be bad, right? That debilitated Venus is supposed to be bad. But that Venus will not be bad. Why it will not be bad? Because that Venus is in Dhanishtha Nakshatra. And Dhanishtha is a good Nakshatra, right? So that is a debilitated in Navamsha, by the way, not even. So debilitated in Navamsha, but still being debilitated in Navamsha also is not bad because that is in Dhanishtha, a good Nakshatra. Are you getting my point? So Nakshatra is very important. And for this particular reason, you know, no matter how the planet is, that planet being in a good Nakshatra is very good, and Pushya, as I told you, is one of the best Nakshatras, right? It gives abundance. So, second Lord in Pushya, abundance of money. 11th Lord in Pushya, abundance of income. 4th Lord in Pushya, abundance of home, family, lands. And abundance of mother. That is good. Many women to help support you, help you prosper, help you grow. That's a good trait, right? 5th Lord in Pushya, many children, many followers. 6th Lord in Pushya, many disease, many enemies. And that doesn't look good now. Right?
I have a question.
Yes, Samarkandji.
You said sometime that 6th Lord on Pushya. So, how to interpret?
Sorry. Come again. Or you can rather write it, like the sound is getting a bit dizzy. I'm not able to listen to the thing completely. But as I can guess, he's asking if the 6th Lord is Jupiter, then how to interpret. It's simple. 6th house indicate disease, Jupiter have nothing to do with disease. Right? So the signification of Jupiter is supported, 6th house is significant. Like both of them are supported. Jupiter supports children, children is there. 6th house supports disease, disease is also there, right? So technically, you know what? No signification of planet and Rashi and house interferes. That is something that 80% of the people don't pay attention to. And let me tell you what. There have been a trend in astrology. What is the planet Rashi and house Karaka for disease? Have you heard of this? You must have heard of this. What is the Rashi, house and planet Karaka for disease? And this is the worst thing that have happened to astrology in 1000 years. This is the worst thing that have happened. Because in that case, you come in a problem. You take any A-grade classic. And tell me where it is written that sadness is the karaka for disease. Nowhere it will be written. When you go to the section, it will say Saturn will indicate bone disease. Sun will indicate this disease. Moon will indicate that disease. Every planet indicates some or other type of disease. There is no particular signification of disease. This particular trend of, you know, which planet indicates disease, it's disease, which planet, which house, which Rashi indicate disease, have confused people. 6th house indicates disease and no planet indicates disease. Direct point. Saturn indicates long-lasting disease because there is no house to indicate long-lasting disease. So 6th house indicates disease, and when Saturn is connected to it, it is a long-lasting disease. But disease is not indicated by Saturn, right? When Mars is connected to it, this will indicate a disease that is coming from accident. When Mercury is connected to it, this is a disease which will come through misuse of medicine. When Sun is connected to it, this will be a disease which comes through the lack of motivation to come out of the disease. It is a disease that will come through depression. And कई लोगों को ये सोचते कि मैं बीमार हूँ बीमारी हो जाती भाई नहीं है तू बीमार Now to tell, getting my point. So yeah, if the Jupiter is the sixth lord and that is in Pushya, children and enemies both are supported, and at no point of time it will interfere. Understand one thing: fifth house indicates Putra, Jupiter indicates Santan. There is a difference between Putra and Santan. Right. Santati is a wider perspective. My child and my younger brother's child, both are my santati. But my putra is what I have given birth to with my legitimate wife. Illegitimate affair, no. That is santati, not putra. There is a differentiation between the fifth house is putra, Jupiter is santati. Difference. But for this particular thing to happen, first of all, you should know Sanskrit or Hindi better. Right. And this is what comes through tradition, right? When you learn in the tradition, you get this particular clarity. So, yeah. Going further, so it is a nakshatra of abundance, give things in abundance. And this is an auspicious nakshatra. This is a good nakshatra. It gives good results, auspicious results, right? So that is something important. Good and auspicious results are given by this nakshatra, right? For YouTube, I will be uploading this particular session later on. Going further, Pushya is an auspicious nakshatra. That is important. Pushya is an auspicious nakshatra. It gives auspicious results, is what we have learned by now. There is a specific word that is used for Pushya, that is Juhyata. Juhyata means the tongue of Agni. It have a tongue like Agni. What does having a tongue like Agni means? It means three things. Right? It means three things. First of all, as I told you, Agni have two tongues, right? So Agni cannot be believed for his words. Agni cannot be believed for his promises. One of the biggest cheaters in Vedic panathan is Agni. One of the biggest ones, right? So in the same way, the Pushya comes with two different tendencies. Pushya does indicate two extremes, right? It is a person who looks very, like, you know, understand it in this particular way, that Pushya may indicate someone who is very clear by appearance but very dirty by thoughts. Getting my point? Two simultaneously different things Pushya can have. So that is something important regarding Pushya that should be taken into consideration. That is meant by tongue of Agni, point one. Tongue of Agni means one more thing, that this person is not very good in conveying what he wants to say. Have a type of Vaksiddhi combination, have a type of a combination where whatever he says comes true. But at the same point of time, this person cannot be, like, you know, this person have a Vaksiddhi combination. Okay, so whatever he tells will come true. But at the same point of time, his voice, his way of speaking, his way of conveying things may not be that much good. That can be problematic. Getting my point? That is the second thing for the tongues of Agni. And third, the tongue of Agni, as I have told you, you know, see, Agni is very calm, right? Agni is very much behind, like, wife of every sage. If you read the Vedic things, Agni is behind every woman, almost. Right? So Pushya cannot be trusted. Pushya cannot be trusted for faithfulness in marital life. For this particular reason, I told you in the starting that Pushya is bad for marriage, right? This is the second thing that is meant by the tongue of Agni. And I will tell you one more thing. Earlier times, whenever there used to be a compromise between two kings, right, there is a peace pact between two kings, three gods were taken as Sakshi. Sakshi means, you know, one who is witnessing it. Like when you get married to a lady, Agni is the witness. For the purity of Sita, Agni was the witness. Right? For friendship, Agni Indra and Mitra. Mitra Varun. Both of them come together. So they are technically four, but it is only taken as Mitra Varuni. So sometimes three, sometimes four. These are considered as someone who looks over the pact. Agni, Indra and Mitra Varuni make sure that whatever peace pact is made right here is will be taken care of. None of the kings will distort the rule of this peace pact. And if any king shows his cleverness and tries to distort the peace pact, then it is the duty of these people to punish. Right? So Agni also comes with punishment, and Agni also comes with being an evidence, right? So whichever planet is in Pushya, you have a very strong karma related to that planet, because Agni have been a witness of all the karmas that you have done in the previous lives regarding that particular planet. One thing is there, because Pushya is a very positive nakshatra. Even if you do bad things related to Pushya in this life, related to the planet Pushya, even if you do bad things, you are not going to get punished right then and there. Bharani will punish you then and there itself, right? Bharani will not take time to punish you. Pushya doesn't have that tendency. Pushya will not punish you then and there. Pushya will be a witness to all of your doings, and it will punish you in your old age, right? Or it will punish you in the next life. So for this particular reason, Pushya is considered good, because he's not going to punish you right now. But it is also considered bad, because at some point of time, he is going to punish you. Generally, for this particular reason, because Pushya is punishing you for the deeds that you have committed in past. Normally, whenever you will see any planet in Pushya, the words will be, sir, I have never done, like if the seventh lord is Pushya, people will be like, sir, I have never done bad in marriage, but still I am suffering. Why? Past lives, right? Past lives. And how to see past lives? Ninth from Jupiter, right? Is what I told in a previous class. Ninth from Jupiter. Although there are many other techniques as well, but ninth from Jupiter. And Jyotish Prakash, people to know about the past life. Now, one more technique. Yeah, that is given by Varahamihira. Ninth from Jupiter is given by Nadi. Okay. And there is a word, Braspates Tishya Juvetah Prastadhi Jamana. Jamana means a worshipper, right? So that indicates Pushya, like for Libra, it is told that Deva Brahmana Pujita. Someone who will worship gods and brahmanas, right? Same is the story with Pushya also, right? Pushya is devoted. Devoted to the gurus, devoted to the ancestors, devoted to the god, right? He is an auspicious religious person, god-fearing, and he is very much into worshipping gods, etc. Right? He also gets favor from gods as well, right? So both the things are there. Getting favor from gods, and the person have a religious outlook, have a religious background, and specifically whichever planet is in Pushya, you should be careful and afraid related to the signification of that planet at the same point of time. Do you get my point? That is important, that is necessary. Okay, there is Jamana technically means worshipper, and also the person for whom the worship is organized, right? Jupiter is a Brahmin, right? So Jamana more indicates a Brahmin. Brahmin will worship God for you, and then you are supposed to worship the Brahmin, right? Devadinam jagasarvam, mantra dinam to devata, mantra brahmana dinam tas brahman devata, right? So Pushya also comes with the fact of, like, whichever planet is in Pushya, if you explore the significations of that planet, if you explore the traits of that planet, you can be famous in the signification of that planet, and people will know you and respect you for the signification of that particular planet, right? So, like, I have my 6,000 Pushya. So people know me for my tactics of handling competition. Like, those who know me personally generally praise me a lot for my way of handling people. You know, how do I handle it? Because I don't believe in a direct fight. I believe in jab loha garam ho to thande lohe pe nahi. And so whichever house Pushya falls, whichever house Cancer falls, you know, you are well versed in that particular thing. Generally, Cancer ascendant people well know how to rise themselves to fame. If you collect the horoscope of 100 people who are born in Cancer ascendant or who have their Lagna Lord in Cancer, you will find that out of those 100 horoscopes, at least 80% of people are famous in their respective fields. Because they know how to work with personality. First house, know how to work with fame. Gemini ascendant will have Cancer in the second house. They know how to earn money. Taurus ascendant people will have Gemini in the third house. They know how to make relationships. Right. Aries ascendant people will have Cancer in the fourth house. And Mars is the karka for property. And because Pushya coming in the fourth house, right? So whichever house Pushya is falling or whichever house Lord is falling in Pushya, you are knowledgeable about that particular thing. You know a lot about that particular thing. Even if you are not learned in that particular branch, still the knowledge is supposed to come, right? Cancer is considered one of the most intellectual signs. Okay. Because fifth from Cancer is Scorpio. And there everyone is debilitated, no one is exalted, right? In front of you, everyone's mati will get brushed. And so that is a good trait, but that is also a bad trait. Because the day when the dream will break, no one will even, you know, converse with you, leave the topic of respecting, right? So for this particular reason, you know, for Cancer, I always advise one particular thing, that be very truthful with what you do. Or for anyone, right? Be very truthful with what you do, because Cancer is an exaltation sign of Jupiter. And having Pushya, Jupiter is also born in Cancer, right? Because Moon in Pushya, when Jupiter was born, that means Moon was in Cancer, right? That is the exaltation of Jupiter, right? So for Cancer people, they should never commit a bad deed. Because Jupiter is just watching you. Jupiter is watching you. You say most successful criminals. They are born in the ascendant where no planet is exalted, debilitated. Leo, Gemini, Aquarius. Maximum criminals you will find there, because there is no one to watch. No one exalted, no one debilitated, right? So no one to watch. Even Scorpio, no exalted, no one to watch. Because you know the planet who is exalted over your ascendant can really take over your head. Right? So you make sure that you do good karma so that Jupiter doesn't take over your head. Otherwise, if it takes, that it will be very bad, right? Tishya is a form of Aditya which gives nourishment. Aditya is sun, a form of sun which gives nourishment, and we have explored the nourishment aspect very in depth before itself, right? So I'm not right, like not too worry much about that. Going further, Pushya also means like, you know, the word Guru. Jupiter, the Lord of Pushya, means someone who will announce something. Right? Someone who will announce something. Ghoshit karna. So Pushya is very much endowed with the ability of supporting someone. You know, Pushya have this trait of like whatever Pushya wants, he can support that particular thing. Right? Pushya is more like, you know, whatever Pushya says is taken as a gospel truth. Right? They are endowed with the power to make someone a king. Right? Endowed with the power to make someone a king. See, understand it in this particular way. The duty of a guru. When a king will die. Right? When a king dies. Or suppose a king have four sons. Out of those four, who is capable to become the next king? Or if the king is having no son at all, who is capable to become the next king will be told by Guru. Guru is the one who will take the hand of the person and will declare it as the king or as the winner, right? So Pushya have the power to declare something for the world, to declare the heir, to declare the person who should be ruling. Getting my point? Is the work of Pushya. Pushya can give fame to other people also. Pushya can give recognition to other people also. Pushya can give credibility to other people also. For this particular reason, see, Jupiter is also called Vachaspati or Vakaspati, whatever you take, right? The Lord of speech or the Lord of words. For this particular reason, people in Pushya should be very careful about. Because Jupiter, as I told you, it is endowed with Vak Siddhi. Vak Siddhi is a particular thing that we were talking before. In the informal session, that is not recorded. Don't ask for it, okay? Vak Siddhi is what we were talking about. And Jupiter is very much related to Vak Siddhi. So whichever planet is in Pushya or whichever house Cancer falls, try not to speak, try to speak very less regarding that particular thing. So if Mars is in Pushya, try not to speak much about I will beat this person or I will kill this person. Mera to man karta hai iski jaan le lu. You don't know when it comes true. Or at least the false allegation of, getting my point? The false allegation of that particular thing may come over you. So, be careful about this particular thing. For Libra people, Cancer comes in the 10th house, right? So don't talk about your profession. For Leo people, Cancer comes in the 12th house, right? Don't talk about your expenses. Because who knows who works in income tax? Right? Be careful. Okay. Brahaspati, Brahmanaspati, as I told you, Brahaspati is also called Brahmanaspati. And Brahmanaspati is someone who is caretaker of money and who is caretaker of grains, right? So Pushya is endowed with the quality of saving things, right? Investing it, saving it. So second lord or the planet influencing money in Pushya is very good for saving money and investing it, right? Investing it at other point of time, right? Saving and investment comes with Pushya. Right. Also, Pushya gives you knowledge about medicines and medication. Okay. Pushya gives you knowledge about medicines and medication. So when moon is in Pushya, you can start taking a medicine or you can go to a doctor to consult a doctor. The remedies will be more and more effective. Right. And if any planet is in Pushya, you know specifically how to see Aushadhi medicine. Take it as the quality of healing. Right. So you know how to heal that particular thing. And there are many nakshatras which are related to healing. Ashwini, Satavisha, Pushya, right? See, my Lagna Lord is in Satavisha. So I can heal personality, right? I can heal a person. So that's why I'm into astrology. So when someone is dejected and depressed and they come to me, I tend to heal their mentality, heal their thinking. I just want to support them. Getting my point? So medication is indicated by Pushya. And Pushya also indicates rain. So rain is an indicative of that Pushya, although is not very emotional, but they will have phases of emotion. For some particular people, they will be extremely biased in emotion. Whereas some other people, they will be completely stone-hearted and will not having any type of emotions towards them. And that is what is indicated by rain. Pushya also indicates someone who is endowed with the duty of protecting the knowledge or protecting some particular thing, right? So when Jupiter is in Pushya, you are endowed with protecting the knowledge. When Lagna is in Pushya, you are endowed with protecting your family, right? So you can be the person who is earning maximum in your family, supporting your family, getting my point. That is what is indicated by Pushya. When it is the third lord in Pushya, you are endowed with the duty to protect your siblings, right? To take care of them, become a father for your siblings. When the fifth lord is in Pushya, then your children are completely highly dependent on you. And so once again, a blessing can become a curse. A curse can become a blessing depending on whether you consult a good astrologer or not. Okay. That is what we are supposed to do as an astrologer, right? Okay, so almost done with stories, and Pushya indicates an arrow, right? So arrow means Pushya is very good for one's own self. Pushya is very good for one's own development, but Pushya is not very good as a person, as someone in a society. You're getting my point? So that is like an arrow. Pushya is focused, pinpointed. Whichever planet is in Pushya, you are supposed to achieve everything related to that planet, right? So if the Venus is in, if the sixth lord is in Pushya, then no matter even if you sit at home, no matter even if you sit at home, you are supposed to get enemies. And if the fourth lord is in Pushya, then no matter even if you sit at home, you are supposed to get comforts, right? That is what is indicated by arrow. You are supposed to get that particular thing for sure. There is no doubt about it. Got my point? Now coming to quickly to the padas of Pushya and the results according to them, right? So the all the four padas of Pushya fall in Cancer, right? And that is the second, third, fourth, and fifth Navamsha of Cancer, right? So the first pada of Pushya goes to Cancer Leo. First pada of Pushya. So coming to the first pada of Pushya, that is a Leo Cancer combination. And I will tell you one very particular thing about Leo Cancer. Either they have no father, okay, like their father dies early, etc., or doesn't support it. And if their father is supportive, then they have no support from the either the maternal family or the paternal family. That is something very crucial that I will say. Like either there is one of the parent is missing, or if both are there, then the support from that particular family of the parent is missing. Point one. Very good for money, very good for wealth, very bad in speech. Vaksiddhi combination is very strong. Person, like whatever person says, whatever person will say, that will come true. Money will be there, respect will be there. This person will be one of the most successful amongst his sibling and family members, right? This person is technically having no competition at all, right? Person is generally spiritual. Marital life is not very good. This person is loyal and will not run behind woman or other things, right? See, this Amavasya combination, the Moon-Sun combinations generally give birth to a spiritualist or someone who is very less interested in sexual affairs, right? So delayed marriage can be there. If marriage is there, then marital life will not be happy for the spouse, as the spouse will not be happy with their approach towards the marriage. Right? It is good for money. It is good for the, like, it is good for children. Such people born in the first pada of Pushya are supposed to get good children, supposed to get children easily. There should not be many problems while, you know, like, while trying to plan for a child, right? It is good for siblings and children. If there is a male child, then they will only have a one male child or one male sibling. If the first child is a female, then they can have multiple siblings or multiple children, mixed gender, right? Half male, half female, kind of a mixed gender, right? They have generally no enmity. They are respected in their field of work. They are respected in the society. That respect is there. Coming to the physical feature, the person will be dark complexion or completely white, right? He will be very quarrelsome, will fight with everyone, right? But will be well versed in fine arts, drawing, understanding things and making it understand to people. Their face will be small. Their eyes will be broad, big, and will not, like, you know, will not focus at one particular thing. They are someone who will always be looking at different things. And someone who have, you know, very chanchal eyes, you know, very, like, the eyelids are never posited on one particular area also. Like, they will be very much devoted to people, and generally the first pada of Pushya indicates someone who is very much devoted to sacrifice for their siblings and their parents, right? Their sacrifice for their family members is there. They sacrifice for their family members, and they will have problems related to legs and knees and bones, right? Coming to the second pada of Pushya, it is good for earning money. Second pada of Pushya is very good for earning money. Siblings are female. Children are female, primarily or only female or primarily female, right? Second pada of Pushya, these people don't have very harmonious relationship with their parents, but have a good relationship with their spouses. Gurus, their relationship is with some gurus they will have good relationship, with some other gurus they will have very bad relationship. At least one part in life is completely missing, right? So either if the marital life is happy, then profession is very normal. If the professional life is successful, then they are like unmarried or very unhappy with their spouse. They are almost ignoring their spouse, right? So one part of the life is extremely missing. The life is filled up of struggle. They are always in the want of someone who cares for them. They are always in the want of someone who understands them, because emotionally no one understands them, or at least they feel that emotionally no one understands them and no one supports them. Right? So it is for every planet. When it is Mars, you take it like, you know, like your, like Mars indicates the thing that you, the things that you support, the things that you think is right. And when Mars is in this second pada of Pushya, at that time you can say that no one supports the anger of the native. Like, you know, like the native is being angry for the right reasons, but no one is supporting him. Everyone is saying that no, you are wrong. Getting my point? And he's not able to convey that I am telling a good point. You people should also follow my point. So you have to, like, you know, mold it accordingly. And I will not promise it. But if time permits, after this particular series of all the 27 nakshatras, I will be doing a series on different planet nakshatras. In 2022, 21, I have many other content to do, right? So 22, you can expect different planet and different nakshatras. It can do. Right? That is on my mind, but after this, completing this particular series, okay? Because I think it is somewhere difficult to mold it for planets. Because to mold it for planets, you need very extensive knowledge that I think is not possessed by many. Going further, the relationship with spouse, although is good, but satisfaction and fulfillment through spouse is not very much there, right? So the relationship is good because of the native. But generally, spouse is not giving you multiple things, right? As you, like, somehow you are just, you know, like being happy with whatever little you are getting and not complaining about what you are not getting. The person is very emotional and generally works based on the things that he feel is right, the things that he feel is good, rather than working for the things that are actually, you know, like this person is not very contemplative on the good and bad aspects of the work, but will choose work based on the emotional aspect, right? A few of the things. This person is logical, very good for money, as I told you, right? Very much interested in reading, writing. The person is scholarly, generally misunderstood, and at least one part of the life is very dormant. And at least one of the parents is like almost invisible from the person's life. This person is fair in complexion. His eyes are beautiful. And he's very good in speaking. Right. Cancer Rashi, Virgo Navamsha, like Mercury exalted. Very good in speaking. Elegant speaker. Will have a soft body akin to that of a female, because Mercury Nepunsak and Moon female. And Mercury in Moon female, so like a very soft body akin to a female, beautiful body, intelligent, Mercury exalted, sparing and light worker, and will be indolent. Now coming to the next part, the Pushya Nakshatra, third pada. Cancer Rashi, Libra Navamsha, right? Moon Venus. Very good marital life. Both of them supports emotion. Emotional person. Very good marital life. Now take natural zodiac, right? Venus is the lord of second house, seventh house. Moon is the lord of the fourth house, right? Will get money from mother. Will have very good property, convenience, happiness is there. Generally goes for love marriage. Like with very happy with their spouse and very happy with their choice of spouse. Marital life is very fulfilling. Right. Added to that, Libra is an exaltation of Saturn. The person is very good in business. He is supported by his co-workers. generally works very generally earns well in stocks and other ways of trading. Good results come after 35 in life. Before 35, things are a bit struck, right? The person will have to try multiple times to achieve something. The things are not easily achievable. His ego is always challenged. His children don't respect him. The, you know, like with children, their relationship is not very good. They may also face some problems while producing children. Specifically up to 30 years of age, their health can be very problematic. Their health can be very challenging, right? And because it is the fourth Navamsha in Cancer, the person is very much happiness oriented. The person is very much comfort oriented. He is not someone who will go out of his comfort zone to work, but is someone who will sit on his comfort zone, will rely more on yantras, remedies to, you know, get benevolence in life rather than going out of the comfort zone and working for it. Because of the fourth Navamsha, generally there is comfort and happiness in life and the person is blessed with convenience, etc. Okay. So I think you people are pretty clear about the technique that I'm using, right? To tell you the result of the Navamsha Pada. And you know what? I'm a very good guy that I'm telling you the technique. Otherwise, I can name it past life karma course. Cannot tell, should not tell you the technique, will tell you 2-3 results and mint money. Nahin. 40,000 for 4 nakshatra. You want to join? Okay. Don't want to join? Okay. Right. But I'm a good guy. You know that. You will realize this later on. Very later on. And you know, like I always tell this to my close people that, you know, 30 years after I die, people will realize, no, this guy was doing something, others haven't done something. But for this, I have to die. That's not an issue. That day is not coming soon. Right. So that is a particular thing. You know, when the person is gone, then you tend to realize what he was doing. Till the time the person is there, you don't. But however, leaving it aside, the fourth Navamsha, the person will be dark in complexion because Libra black in color. Right. The person will have like beautiful eyebrows, once again a trait of Venus. Will be graceful in appearance, trait of Venus. Will have charming eyes and nose, trait of Venus. Will be courageous, liberal, will perform acts prescribed for superior castmen and will be crafty. Once all the attributes of Venus, right? Because it is Cancer Rashi and Libra Navamsha. The next one, the fourth pada of Pushya, Cancer Rashi and Scorpio Navamsha, right? Moon debilitated. Mentally frustrated, mentally anguished, desires not getting fulfilled. Moon is the karka for money. Right. So not good for money. Person may not be able to achieve things, even if he will achieve things after spending like, you know, 40, 45 years of life, because good results will come late. Right. The sign lord itself is debilitated. So the person will be humiliated. What else does Lagna lord indicate? The person will be like, you know, will be in false accusation, right? You know, like will be blamed for something that he have never done. There will be many health problems. Lagna lord indicates health, right? There will be many health problems. The life will be challenging. The person will specifically be troubled by the bad thoughts that he is having and the bad company that is there with him. Okay. This is being the fifth Navamsha once again in Navtara. The fifth is not very good, right? So the life is challenging. The person have to spend multiple years in vain to get some good results. Generally, the good results of life come after 40, 45 only. Before that, the things are quite difficult. The person have to struggle, right? But all these things are there only if the person is not adopted or if his mother is alive. If the person is separated from his mother or adopted, or if his mother is not alive, then the good aspect of Pushya will tend to come there. And in that scenario, it will be good. The good traits of the native is the person is well in planning. The person is scholarly. The person is intelligent. The person will have many children. He will also have happiness from children. And all the struggles that he will face in life before 40, all that struggles will be heavily rewarded by the fame, money, and support of his children. Right? The fifth from Cancer, right? The person will be able to accumulate a good amount of gold in life. and will be blessed after crossing his middle age. Right? Such person's voice will be akin to the sound of a bell. That means a very harsh voice, that a very, you know, a very karkash, not good to listen type of voice. That is because moon is debilitated in the Navamsha. Right? The person will be crooked. Once again, moon debilitated, right? Crooked, not good in his mentality. He will have allied eyebrows and very long arms. Long arms is a trait of a debilitated moon. Right? He will be interested in woman. Once again, the moon mind is afflicted, so interested in woman. Right? He will be bereft of dutifulness. Lagna law debilitated, cannot complete anything. Right? He will injure others and will not be very intelligent. Will not be very intelligent. This particular result is only when the mother is alive and the person is living with mother. If he is separated with mother, or the mother is not alive, or if the person is given to adoption, then the bad results will not be there, whereas the good results will be there. So just the opposite of the bad, the good results will be there, right? So I'm pretty sure that you know how I am telling you the result of the Navamsha. The result of the Navamsha versus the result of the Pada of the Nakshatra, both are the same, right? Because one Navamsha is one Pada of the Nakshatra. Right? So rather than treating it as the secret of the Nakshatra Padas, first time in astrology in 1000 years, great research, let me tell you the truth, right? Because the tongue gets the blemish of speaking lie and fooling people. Remember what my guru said to me. That you think no one is watching at you. But you're wrong. In the idol of Jagannath, there are two big eyes only. No hands, no legs, only two big eyes. He's looking everywhere. You think no one is looking? No. He's looking. So that is a particular thing. Okay. And this is for the Pushya class. I'm done with it. Right, so next class we will continue with the next nakshatra oscillation.